Welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to talk about superhero typography and approaches to create this. So let's start with this. I'm going to zoom out. Here's the base artwork. This is just the text and some stars. And there are several approaches to this. Let's first take a look at some approaches that are not very suitable in some occasions. So I'm going to copy that and let's outline the text. I'm going to use the shortcut for that. And now we have the text outlined. We need that because I want to use the free transform tool and make this a free transform and then bring this in the shape of my superhero typography, like make this perspective looking like so somehow, and this is okay. And now I'm going to make a copy of this. I'm going to need that later, and I'm going to make another copy, just copy and then paste it back by using the shortcut again. And then let's make this smaller, much smaller, like so. And also I'm going to apply a different color to this. So let's make this somewhat dark violet. And let's now select the two. And one of the approaches to this is to use blend. So I'm going to object blend make. This makes just one step, which is correct. Let's double click the blend tool and let's make several more steps. And you need a lot of them. Let's make 900 steps. And then we've got a nice blend. And you see, this gives this a nice perspective. And you could vary this. You could apply gradients to both of those objects and then you get a nice blend. But when you zoom in, you get this along the edge. Now you could say, okay, when I print this, then everything will be fine because it's just, you know, the resolution will swallow most of that. And if you put a stroke along the lines, then it will be hidden anyway. And that is correct. That's what will be happening. But maybe you need this for different things. So maybe you need this in order to cut something out of foil and pop this up on your storefront or whatever. And in that case, you would need really a shape of this. And then it gets tricky. So what you would need to do that then is you need to expand this blend and then use Pathfinders on it. So let's first take a look at it in outline view, again with the shortcut. And you see, this is nice and clean, not too many objects. That is okay. So what happens when you expand that? Let's go to Object, Blend, Expand, like so. And you see, this is already a little suspicious. So let's go into outline view again. And here are the paths. So Illustrator has now created all those 900 steps that we wanted. This is something that might get you into trouble when printing as well, because all of these paths get sent to the printer. It might be somewhat demanding to their hardware. So let's take a look at it. In window, in the document info, we can see how many objects there are. And you see, there are 16,000 paths and they have 400,000 points. And this is something that not every printer might like a lot. So let's go here again. And so let's take a look at what happens when you use Pathfinders on it. And I'm going to make sure first that I have saved that because Pathfinders will have a hard time. So let's unite it. And you see on this M1 Mac, it already takes some time to process this and maybe Illustrator will still crash with it. And then we have a problem with our artwork because then it will get tricky to proceed with it. Illustrator is still chewing at it. Let's just stop it. So what we could do with this now is ungroup it and then make this in small chunks and go further with uniting it. So let's ungroup it. Let's see what we've got. Still some groups. And like so, this is nice. So let's ungroup it again. And what I could now do is, you know, select a chunk of it and unite that. And maybe this will be processed faster. There we are. And then zoom in and you see we've got this kind of edge. And now it will get really tricky to simplify that. And this will be hard for a plotter to cut because all these small things, that's not very nice. So this approach is suitable when you want to export this to pixels. But when you need paths, this is not very suitable as an approach. There is a similar approach, and that's why I have this copy, which is to go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and use Transform on that, and then make a very small move. I'm going to get to 0.1 millimeters, which is already too much. But just to show you what happens, I'm going to make, let's make 40 copies of this. And you see this one happens. It gets expanded as well. And maybe I should have a different movement in this. So let's go to the appearance panel again and let's set up a different movement for this and make this to -0.1, and you see this looks more like the effect I wanted. And also, when doing this, what you can do is make this smaller so that you get this nice superhero looking thing. So, like so. Again, when you see this in outline view, it looks unsuspicious. It looks clean, but the edges look like this. And when there's rounds, you see it looks like this, which is also not desirable. And again, when this gets sent to a printer, it won't look just as nicely because then it will be expanded as well. And you have the same thing as with the blend. So this as well is suitable when you want to export to pixels, but not when you need vector artwork. Let's take a look at a different approach. So let's take this and I'm going to use Effect, 3D and Materials, but not the materials, but the classic effect, and extrude that. And here we can set up that superhero thing and make the perspective in this like so and set this up in the way we need it. So let's make this slightly longer. And again, you can rotate this in the way you want it, like this. And I'm going to make a stronger perspective, like so. You have to be kind of cautious about the perspective because sometimes Illustrator just can't do that. This is actually extreme in a way that it's already getting dangerous. So let's go to OK and take a look at it. And this looks nice. But how do we get from this to the result below? Because this has all these gradients in it, and that's something that shouldn't be in there. So how do we proceed from here? Let's go to the appearance panel again and edit that. And what we can do is set this shading to no shading. So what about that? That doesn't look at all like what we wanted. But this is kind of important because now what we need to do again is expand the appearance. And I'm going to undo that because there's one other thing that's important. You have to show all the options, like more options, and make sure that you do not draw hidden faces. They are hidden anyway. We don't need them. So, and now let's go to expand appearance. And when you look at this in outline view, then you see we have few shapes. And those are all very suitable. We have very clean edges and we can use all of this. So this is, of course, grouped. Let's take a look at it in the layers panel and let's go to it. I'm going to click the zoom tool here. So to find it, and you see it's not very well arranged hierarchically, so we need to sort this. But okay, let's first ungroup that stuff, and we need to ungroup this again, and then first select those letters. You can just figure out where they are, like so. We need the faces. We need to color those first. And there's another star, like so. And they get this yellow color, and then let's just group them. And I'm going to change that to blue again. And then we're going to copy this and paste it in front, like so. And then let's make this yellow, like this. Okay. And now what we can do is go to select same fill color. And you see Illustrator has selected this one in the bottom as well. So let's first select it and let's lock it. And then let's do this again. So select same fill color and group them. And this as well. Select same fill color and group those as well. So they are easier to select now. And if you want to apply a stroke to it, then you can create a stroke for this group and make this a little lighter and then move this stroke below the contents like so. We have a nice stroke. So the next thing is we need to create those shadows. And there again, you can just select those faces as you like and then color them. So let's take the color panel and then we can make them darker, like so. You can just select them and then pick up the color, but we can also do something different. I'm going to undo that because I need to press the shift key. What we can also do is now that this color is loaded, you can just, you know, figure out where the shapes are and then press Alt and paint this color in there. But that doesn't work. Now it does. So paint that color into them and get those things shaded. So this will take a little time, but still it takes less time than clean up the other things. And you see the shape is already shaping. We are getting closer to our superhero look, like so. So maybe you also want these nice edges in here, you know, the lighter edges that I have in there. So what can you do about those? What I have done is just taking the direct selection tool and then make sure you hit really that path segment. So that segment, and then copy that and deselect and paste in front. And then you can apply a stroke color to that, like so, and also apply a width profile and of course make that stroke a little thinner so that you get these nice lighting into this artwork. The other thing you could do about it is use live paint. So you could make live paint groups, and then you can also color those strokes. If you want to go the live paint route, what I would do is not make a live paint group of all of this at once, but make live paint groups, several of them. So make a live paint group of this star, and make a live paint group of this woman lettering. And because in the live paint group, if you would make this of all of them, so what you would have in it is all of these short segments that you need to color. And well, that might be more work than when you have several live paint groups of each of those words. So that's how you can do this kind of lettering in a clean way with not too many shapes. And this can be sent to the printer as a vector artwork. You do not need to convert this to pixels.